simple, and straightforward. The Block Editor of WordPress is perfect for blogging, but it has some limitations when you want to change the color of your text, typography, and things like the size of your text or separate adjustments for the mobile view. Hello WordPress enthusiasts and welcome to our channel. My name is Robert, and in this video I will compare Elementor versus the Block Editor of WordPress when it comes to blogging. When you create a new blog post with the default editor of WordPress, it will start with the paragraph block automatically, where you just need to put your words together to create your first two or three sentences. For more titles and subtitles, you should use the H2 heading block. For titles, and H3 for subtitles. Fast forward, if I write an article about the best WordPress themes, for example, I would start with the title, which would be 10 best WordPress themes of all time. Then I have to write a short introduction, followed by an H2 title, which would be the name of the first theme. If I want to break down the description of each theme, I would add two more subtitles for features and design, for example. For each theme, I would use a picture to show a print screen of the first page from the demo. At the end, my blog post will look something like this, and I can put some buttons in the description to link the demo and the sales page of each theme with those buttons. To make money, you can use affiliate links in those buttons. For example, you can promote Themeier products, I mean themes and plugins, through our affiliate program on shareasale.com and earn a 55% commission for each sale. Let me show you how to write the same article, but with the free version of Elementor, and what are the pros and cons of doing it with a page builder plugin. If Elementor is already installed on your dashboard, you can see the Edit with Elementor big blue button above when adding a new post. Before clicking that button, you should add the title, categories, tags, and the featured image, which are things you can't control through the Page Builder editor screen. Once you finish these steps, you can click Save Draft or Publish, which you need to click twice, and then click on the Edit with Elementor button. You have the default template selected in the Page Layout options, and you can switch that to Elementor Canvas, which will show up as a blank page without header and footer. Alternatively, you can select the Elementor Full Width template, which will enable the header and footer of your website, but you won't see the title of your article. To make that happen, select the cover or the full width template. These templates are generated by the active theme on your dashboard and by Elementor. So, if you stay with the default template, you get the title, the featured image, as well as comments and other WordPress elements below. The Elementor handles are here in the center, where you need to add a paragraph block first. This block is not there by default as it is in the Block Editor of WordPress, so I think the default WordPress editor is more user-friendly for bloggers. To add a paragraph block, go to Elements and drag over the heading block. You may be tempted to use the text editor, which is totally fine, but the heading block is much simpler, even though you have fewer features. This would be the introduction of your blog post, and the HTML tag of this block will be paragraph. If you want to make a portion of your text bold, select that text and use the controls above. Also, I think that the weight of the text should be 300 instead of the default, which is too thick. If you want to insert hyperlinks, like click here to see the demo and buy this theme, you better use the text editor block, which allows doing that. The following block is an H2 title for the first theme or whatever else you write about. To make things faster, duplicate the heading block and make it smaller by selecting the H3 tag. Let me go to Preferences and change the theme from light to dark. And activate the editing handles, which will help me move even faster. It will allow using the duplicate feature on hover instead of using the right-click feature over and over again. Okay. One more thing before moving on is to change the primary color in the default settings from this ugly blue to black or a dark shade of gray. Cool. Now that I have these widgets, I can duplicate them as many times as I need. If I have 10 themes, I should duplicate the heading 2, 9 times. And because I have features and design, H3 headings for each theme, I need to duplicate each subtitle 9 times. The advantage of using Elementor instead of the default WordPress editor is that you can adjust the size of your elements separately for desktop and mobile view. Another important thing is that you can save your article as a template and reuse it for another article about the best WordPress themes for blogging or e-commerce. I think you got the idea. To get rid of the space above the first paragraph widget, go to the Advanced tab of your section and in the padding settings, use 0. Duplicate the paragraph widget as many times as you need, and finally add the images to each theme. At the end, you can use Preview and Buy Now or Download buttons, which can be connected with your affiliate links. To do that, drag over an intersection widget below the last paragraph of a theme. Set the padding to 0, and then drag over a button which should have the justified alignment. Style the button as you want, name it Demo, paste your affiliate link in this field, check to open that link in a new window, and then duplicate it. Now you need to change the name of the following button to Buy Now or Download, and that's it. As you've probably already noticed, with Elementor you have way more possibilities to customize the elements of your blog post, which is a huge advantage. Just be careful with the HTML tag of your titles and subtitles, which should be H2 for titles and H3 for subtitles. If you right-click on the title of your blog post and inspect the code, you will see that it uses the H1 tag, which is perfect for SEO. To fine-tune the aspect of your article, you can use the spacer widget as well as the accordion widget to make the features and design description boxes interactive. At the end, let me compare the look and feel of both blog posts. This is the article made with the default block editor. while this is made with Elementor. Which one is better? Well, if you don't care too much about things like changing fonts, adjusting element sizes for mobile view, and other custom features that Elementor offers, you can stick to the simple and straightforward editor of WordPress. Alternatively, you can use the advanced heading block of Otter, which is available once you activate the Gutenberg Blocks and Template Library plugin. It will give you access to more fonts in the typography settings, animations, and you will be able to adjust the size of a title or subtitle separately for desktop, tablet, and mobile. Now that you know the pros and cons of using the default editor of WordPress versus Elementor for blogging, I'm curious, what do you think and what would be your way to write articles? I prefer the block editor, but for a blog post with more possibilities, I would try Elementor.